In starting the design process to figure out what is the right building for the college, there are many different factors that come into play. For a building of this magnitude, longevity is critical. That, however, is more difficult in a science building because science is constantly changing. So flexibility, along with longevity, along with efficiency and beauty, and all of those good things, have to be accommodated together. My name's Tom Davies. I'm the Director of Design and Construction here at Amherst College. The new Science Center is by far the most significant construction project that the college has ever taken on. We are, from a sustainability perspective, anticipating that this building will be a standard bearer in that regard. We're modeled to attain a EUI, which is an energy usage intensity index that is less than half of what a typical new science building would consume. So it's technically very advanced. The building is about 250,000 square feet. Over the course of the project, it will take roughly 750,000 worker hours. We're going to consume over 2,000 truckloads of concrete, roughly 45 miles of piping, 250 miles of wire. The primary design feature of the building is that the building is really putting science on display. Large walls of glass facing the campus. Once you're inside the building, you'll be looking right into the laboratories, both the teaching laboratories as well as the research laboratories, seeing all the activity that happens in there. Something about Amherst College that's very different from most other schools is that our undergraduates are very involved with faculty research. And so this is a way to not only make that very apparent, but also make it a really welcoming and nice environment for those students working late into the night in these laboratories. It's beautiful, it's efficient, it works well, it's rational. It takes what was a kind of forgotten piece of the campus down here and turns it into something that's really central and fantastic.